after you have completed your Jumma Salat, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Go out in the earth and acquire halal risk. I have performed my Jumma and now I'm going out in the earth to go in. نَحْمَدُهُ وَنُسَلِّي وَنُسَلِّمُ عَلَى رَسُولِهِ الْكَرِيمِ أَمَّا بَعْدُ. Respected viewers and listeners, we have heard this cliche many a times and the statement that in Islam there is no dichotomy between dunya and deen and between the spiritual and the mundane. There is no dichotomy. Both of these are part of our deen and both of these are part of coming closer towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that in other religious communities and other isms and ideologies, that these two have been put into watertight compartments. This is dunya, this is the worldly matter, this is religion, this is a religious matter, and the twain shall never meet. As it has been explained, render unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and render unto God what is God. In Islam, we do not believe in that concept. We believe that our entire life is governed by the commands of Almighty Allah. Our entire life can become ibadah. We know that there are certain acts that are known for devotion, which are known as ibadat. Those are definitely ibadat. It is a means of devotion. It is an ibadat. It is a means of coming closer towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salat, zikr, tilawat. These are known to be acts of ibadat. But even mundane activities, activities which you and I would many a times regard as dunya, regard as part of the mundane, regard as got nothing to do with deen. However, if we do those deeds with a proper intention and do it with a proper methodology, it becomes part of deen. It is deen. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that acquiring halal risk is not a worldly matter. It is talabul halali faridatun. It is a religious obligation. And I can't explain this better than an incident of a sahabi by the name of Arraq bin Malik, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When he used to come out of the masjid on the day of Jum'ah, on the door of the masjid, he used to say these words, Allahumma inni ajabtu da'wataka wa sallaytu faridataka. Oh Allah, I have heeded your call to leave everything and come and perform Jum'ah. I have performed my Jummah Salat as you have commanded. وَنَشَرْتَنِي كَمَا أَمَرْتَنِي. And now I am going out as you have commanded in the very same surah which tells people to go for Jummah Salat. After فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ السَّلَاتِ. After you have completed your Jummah Salat, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Go out in the earth and acquire halal risk. I have performed my Jummah and now I'm going out in the earth to go in. Earn halal risk as you have commanded. Allah says in Surah Alam Nashra, فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. Although this is for our beloved Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, ulama have said it is a lesson for us. You have completed your other responsibilities, now tire yourself in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in turning towards Almighty Allah. Look at the beautiful, seamless connection. After you have performed Jumu'ah, go out and earn halal risk. After you have completed your task, go and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make our entire life one of ibadat, for there is no dichotomy between the two in Islam.